Hi guys, today I discuss one new project. The project name is College Feedback Management System. So this College Feedback Management System implemented in another application. So this application provides an easy way to know information about the faculty and about a college. So in this application and all the information about the college, about the faculty, all about the students, everything will be added by the admin. So and then by this application, student can easily find the details about the college and about the faculty. So which faculty have the how much of experience, and which faculty have the how much of the subject knowledge. Everything can easily find about this application. So which will helpful for freshers, those who are searching for the good faculty, those who are searching for a college. So the main aim of this application is in our existing we are facing lot of problem, like there is no proper information about the faculty, there is no proper information about the college. If I want to know the proper information about the faculty, like is this faculty teaching is very well or not, I need to inquiry from other persons. Like if I'm inquiry from other persons, it'll take lot of time, and it maybe is like he's telling like maybe he's a good feedback or bad feedback, we doesn't know. So based on that, physically we'll put more effort, and we'll take lot of time so to know about the faculty, to know about the college. So students is not able to give feedback directly. So that reason, to overcome that problems, so in our application we'll implement the College Feedback Management System. So in this application, students can easily find searching about the college, students can easily know about the faculty's feedback and faculty information. So by the added information about the faculty, they can easily give the feedback about the faculty. So and then the freshers can easily access the information about the college and about the faculty, and then there is no this system saves lot of time and effort for the students. So there is no and the system also provide a chance for students give a feedback about the college and about the faculty without any hesitate and without any fear. So this concept will implemented in through another application. So like this way. So this application, we have three modules, like one module is an admin, and one module is Android, and another module is student. So here admin role is like a administrator of the complete application. Like in our college, we have one principal. So like principal administrator every faculty, every student. Now like this, in our application also, administrator can handle every faculty and every students. So you can, in our application, admin login with his username and password. So like he is administrator, so that reason he is no need to register. So by this default username and password, he is logged into our application. The username is an admin, the password also be admin. If I am giving the username and password is wrong, check invalid login details. If the username and password both are correct, then admin login into the home page. The default username password knows only the administrator only. So after logging into the admin, so admin can view, can do those all the operations like add faculty. Those who are working in our college, he can add the all the faculties. So in that add the faculty details, we'll get the faculty name, faculty ID, faculty email, and faculty phone number. So I'll give faculty phone name like faculty name like Dhatri. And faculty ID 6789, and his email and phone number. Oh, I'm giving phone number like 1, 2, 3. Check. So phone number should be 10 numbers. Okay. So I'll give correct phone number. So I'm clicking add button. So faculty added success. So in case in future I want to update the faculty details, or I want to delete the faculty details, so when I'm clicking the view faculty, I'll get those who are available in our application, all the faculty details are displayed here. So if I want to update the faculty details, I'm click an update button, I'll get all the available details. I'm giving Dhatri solutions. Add the faculty name updated. So if I want to delete, and when I'm clicking delete button, the details will be deleted. Same like admin can add the students. Here the student form will have some fields like a student name, student roll number, semester, and then section and student phone number. I'm giving a student name like Shravani, roll number. If I'm giving wrong roll number, we'll get how the output like check. When I'm clicking select valid branch and phone number. So because of I'm not selecting any semester branch now, so the reason need to select. I'm giving the Shravani for the 4-1 semester. He is in A section. I'm clicking add button. Again, I'm getting one pop-up like the phone number should be 10 numbers. Okay, then again I'm clicking again. I'm getting one pop-up like the roll number should be not correct. Okay, here I'm entering my roll number. Now clicking add button. Now all the details are added. If same like when you are clicking a view students, all the added student details will be visible here. If you want to update the student details, you can update here and click on add. The next view student details. The next add subject. Here admin can add the subjects. These subjects can assign by the faculty. So I am adding the subject for CHC branch for the 4-1. The subject name is Java. If I'm selecting, I'm not selecting branch, I'm not selecting semester, I'm clicking, I'm invalid branch and invalid semester. So I'm selecting the CSC and I'm selecting the semester. So when I'm giving correct details, then only the details will be added. The next, faculty feedback. Still no student doesn't give any faculty details. That is the reason when I'm clicking no chart data available. In this our application, all the feedback details visible in the chart format. So in here we will give feedback. We'll see feedback like faculty wise. This is the faculty's roll numbers. Faculty IDs. We can view the feedback like semester wise and branch wise. We can see both ways because of still right. No one students doesn't give any feedback. Right, I'm giving. That is the reason. The no chart, no data will be available. So here based on that ID faculty login here. So when I'm clicking the faculty ID 6789, I'm clicking login. So based on that my ID, I'll get some OTP. So every time I'm login, I'll get one new OTP. So the OTP is 877-6724. My OTP is 8. So every new login I'm getting new OTP. If I'm entering wrong OTP, I'm getting like invalid OTP. If I'm enter correct OTP, then you show the valid OTP. If I'm enter valid OTP, I'm entered to the faculty homepage. So in that faculty assign subjects. Based on that assigning, he need to select the first semester and then branch. So based on the semester, semester and branch, the automatically the available subjects are displayed here. So I'm adding only one subject, like admin added only one subject now. So those based on that, I'm getting only one subject here. So the login faculty assign the subject like in 4-1 semester in CSC branch, I'm assigning the Java subject here. The subject assigned success. He can view all the assigned subject details like subject name Java, branch CSC, the semester is 4-1. So this faculty teach the subject for the students. And then faculty can view all the feedback details about faculty can view his feedback details and he can view feedback details like in short way also. So still now no student doesn't give any feedback, right? That is the reason I'm they're showing like empty here. The student now the student role, student login with his roll number is 14 MIT. 580 based on his roll number, the automatically the branch will be assigned for the student. Login, enter into the, so every new login I'm getting one new OTP. The OTP is 8298. Because if I'm giving another number, na, the OTP get sent to some another number. So I'm giving here OTP like 8298966662. If I'm giving invalid OTP, I'll get like invalid OTP. So if I have OTP is valid, I'm entered into the home page. So student can view all the subject details. He's based on his semester, based on his subject. Based on his semester, based on his branch, he'll get all the subject details here. If the student want to give feedback from this subject, click on give feedback. So here the feedback details like subject knowledge, communication, presentation skills, punctuality, control over the class, ability, professionalism, content of the lecture, clarification of the doubts, explanation with example, and finally he give about faculty feedback. So if I am selecting like subject knowledge, yeah, I'm giving rating like 8, communication 6, presentation 7, punctuality 10, control of the class 6. Depends upon the faculty, I'm giving the rating here. 7, 4. Here the comment is like if you want to give the comment, you can give, or else it's an optional. So I'm giving a comment like, yeah, good teaching skills, submit. This feedback added by the faculty. So when I'm not selecting anything, I'm clicking submit. So please choose rating. Okay, so already I'm giving this rating for this faculty. Again I'm try to giving as a one more time. It's added or not, we will see it. I'm getting feedback already entered. So the only one, the one student can give feedback from at one time for the faculty. Logout. Then admin can view all the feedback details about the faculty. After logging into the admin, we can view feedback about the faculty. When he is clicking faculty feedback, you need to choose the faculty roll numbers, because of still we have only one faculty, that is the reason I'm getting only one faculty ID. When I'm clicking submit button, he'll get, based on his Java subject, he'll get 68 rating about the teaching skills. This is an individual faculty rating. If you want to see the semester wise feedback, I need to select the semester like 4-1. A section submit. So based on this semester, by this subject, based on the subject, he'll get 58% of teaching skills about the one faculty. So like if you are giving any more subjects, he'll get one by one here. This is the feedback can view by the admin. Then faculty also can see his feedback details. 3358356 my OTP. 3 5 8 3 5 6 1. Then here faculty can view about his feedback details. The subject name Java, branch CSC, semester 4-1. Subject knowledge you can view through text wise. If you want his feedback through a graph format, you can view like here, like this. So this is our complete application format. So thank you.